Bizzibox's expert information on cheese production. What is the process of making cheddar?
Basically, what we do is we start off with milk. We just use our own milk, so we've got 65 cows on this farm. We pipe the milk in through the red pipe over there and heat it up. You're basically heating up the milk so you're growing bacteria, so it kind of goes against the grain of other food processes. You want to get it nice and warm, not too hot, not too cold, so the bacteria flourish. So therefore you need very clean milk, because obviously all the bacteria will grow, so you want just the good ones. And then what we do is we add cheese bacteria, special bacteria. So we put that into the milk, heat it up to about 32 degrees and let them go crazy. Once the bacteria have grown to a point, and you can tell that by measuring the acidity, we add rennet. And rennet is the enzyme of a calf's stomach, which is where the sort of you get vegetarian cheeses which don't use animal rennet, but we use animal rennet here. And what that does is it makes the milk set from a liquid to a solid. So it kind of goes like a stiff yogurt. Once the milk has set, we cut the curds, so that they're in curds now, so we call the set cheese a curds. We cut them with knives, and basically we form very small cubes of curds, and then as we cut, the curds release whey. So it's kind of a strange process unless you see it, but you end up with a vat full of mainly liquid with small lumps of curd floating in the liquid, and that is the curds in the whey. So once we've cut the curds, we take the temperature up slightly higher, and we cook the curds for about an hour and a half at about 40 degrees, so not very warm at all, but just cook them through so they go quite firm, because they're very delicate when you first cut them. And once the right texture is reached, and also once the right acidity is reached, we drain away all of the whey, which we use for the farm. We spread it on the land here, or some local pig farmers come and collect it to feed their animals. So we drain off the whey, and then we go through a process called cheddaring. And cheddaring is quite unique to cheddar making, where all of the curds sort of stick back together into a sort of slab, and we cut those slabs into blocks and stack them up. And what this does is it creates the right texture that we're after, and also the acidity that we're after. And this process takes about an hour of working the curds, stacking them on top of each other, turning them, stacking them, and they end up in the texture of a cooked chicken breast, so a sort of stringy texture. Once we're at that stage, we mill the curds. We put them through a mill to cut them up into small chunks again, and we add salt, just 2% salt, and then we put them into the molds and press them. Big pneumatic press. All the cheeses sit in a row, and then the piston there squeezes them together, and they come out like this. These are 10-kilo cheeses. We make them slightly smaller. A traditional Somerset cheddar would be made in a 25-kilo round, but we go for the 10 kilos, partly because they're more manageable to handle, partly because we're not on such a large scale, and they work very well for us. So once we're at this stage, the cheese is then prepared for the storeroom, where they go and sit in the storeroom for anything between 9 and 18 months. They're basically put onto wooden shelves. The wood allows the cheeses to breathe, because you don't want them to sweat. It's quite an extraordinary thing. You're taking a dairy product and putting it into a room which is not that cold, it's at 12 degrees, and just leaving it on shelves for anything up to 3 years, some cheddars can be in there. But basically what's preserving it is the acid within the cheese and also the salt, so it preserves it, and it actually matures and gets flavour over that period of time. It also grows a rind, so it will end up with a nice rind which is formed from moulds. But to maintain the cheeses in the store, we have to make sure that they're turned regularly, because what happens is the moisture sinks and the cheeses sag a bit, so we have to keep turning them. So once every 2 to 3 weeks we just flip them over, which is quite a labour of love, because there are quite a few in there, but it doesn't take long to go through them all.
What happens in the cheese store?
This is our cheese store. We We have about a year's worth of production in this store, which equates to about 1,200 cheeses. We keep the cheeses for at least a year at the moment. And every 2 to 3 weeks, we have to turn them end on end. The temperature in here is 12 degrees, and the humidity is about 90 degrees. We're basically recreating the conditions that you would find in a cave, because traditionally, cheeses would have been stored in caves or larders, and that's how the sort of recipes developed. So these conditions are very similar to that you'd find to sort of a cave or a cellar.
What happens during the maturation phase?
During the maturation time, the cheese is always losing moisture, but it's also the bacteria within the cheese are always developing and growing. So the flavors develop and become much more complex. So for a traditional cheddar, you want to start with a fairly dry curd, and that will develop into sort of a longer maturing cheese where you won't get so much flavour up front. A lot of block cheddars are made quite wet, so they have a very pasty texture, but you want a good sort of bite to a cheddar, a traditional cheddar anyway. It should break in a sort of flinty type way, as opposed to sort of crumbling down to a paste. It also grows a mould rind, so over a period of time, the moulds will grow on the surface of the cheese, they'll keep dying back, and it develops a sort of leathery rind, which is a true sign of a traditional cheddar.
www.bizzibox.com